SkyWatch Media News for July 31st, 2019. Here's what's happening. A massive coronal hole has formed in the upper atmosphere of the Sun, which will head directly towards Earth on the same day that our planet is covered in the mysterious dark light of a black supermoon. The first stream of cosmic particles will arrive on August the 1st, followed by two more blasts in rapid succession on August 4th. Whenever a warning is issued that involves an Earth-directed coronal mass, it becomes a concern because coronal holes are breaches in the Sun's magnetic field which allow massive plumes of plasma to burst out from the Sun's upper atmosphere. If the Earth aligns with the burst of energy, it has the potential to initiate dangerous geomagnetic storms. There are three of these solar threats now aimed at the northern hemisphere and the upper reaches of our planet that are certain to have power companies on edge. A direct hit from a powerful blast of solar energy could cripple the electric grid, plunging much of our planet into total darkness, which, in a worst-case scenario, would result in a direct loss of communications across the Earth. This is a frightening prospect, one that is already shared by numerous researchers in the field of solar science. The threats and the consequences of a dynamic solar storm similar to the 1859 Carrington event were recently shared by maverick geologist Randall Carlson and historical theorist on extinction-level events.
Just elaborated on the Carrington event of 1859, and that was, of course, the most recent one that, was of that particular scale, although there have been quite a few others. For example, radionuclides are showing up in ice cores, showing that there have been equivalent events multiple times in history. One huge event that was dated to 660 BC, another one that was dated to 775 AD. Then there was the coronal mass ejection of July 23rd, 2012, which was probably even more powerful than the Carrington event of 1859. But luckily, it was directed into space so that it missed Earth. If it had hit the Earth, we would probably still be recovering from that event. But luckily, we were about, it crossed Earth's orbit about 9 days apart from when our planet was there. Well, power plants would go down, substations would go down, transmission lines, cell phone towers would go down. There'd be pretty much a collapse of the electronic grid system that we all depend on, and it could last anywhere, depending on the severity of the event, anywhere from days to weeks, even months, to get back online. This would mean that, basically large portions of the planet could be plunged into darkness, no electricity, no means of communication. Everything that you depend on, your refrigerator, gone, air conditioning, gone. Pumping stations are going to be down. Therefore, you wouldn't even be able to flush your commode. It would be, for portions of the Earth, it would be like going back to the Dark Ages again, because we've become so dependent. Our, the thousands of satellites that we depend on for our global telecommunication systems, they could be severely damaged. So, yeah, I mean, it could be a major event. And, NASA in 2014 estimated that there could be about a 12% chance of having a Carrington level or greater event within the next 10 years, up to 2024. So this is a very real thing. It's not hypothetical. It's not science fiction. There was even a minor event that happened in, I believe it was 1989. Yes, it was 1989. There was a relatively minor coronal mass ejection event that caused major power outages in Quebec, Canada, that led to people being out without power from several days up to several weeks. And that was a relatively minor event. It depends on the extent. If it's a short-lived event, obviously the face of the Earth that's towards the sun is going to receive the full brunt of it. When that solar, when the CME comes in, what it does is it compresses the Earth's magnetosphere on the front side and creates a long magnetic tail on the back side of the Earth. So it all depends on how long it lasts. If it only lasts a few hours, yes, it's going to be pretty much disruptive to the whatever hemisphere of the Earth is facing the sun. If it lasted for much longer than that, like 12 or 14 or 16 hours or longer, yes, then it could encompass the whole planet. You see, so yes, the face of the Earth, the hemisphere of the Earth that's facing the sun, when that CME or that solar flare comes in, is going to suffer the most extreme damage. Well, it depends on the severity. And I think that we're looking at, we're learning. Each day that goes by, you know, we've had solar satellites up observing the sun for a number of decades now, and pretty much every year we're learning more about how truly dynamic the sun really is. So I think that, you know, we might be faced with the possibility of something even, say, an order of magnitude beyond the Carrington event. And in that case, we've got some major trouble on our hands.
The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration has warned that the incoming solar storm will produce elevated geomagnetic levels, but it may not actually produce the disastrous solar particles that were described by Carlson. Even so, power companies are preparing their grids in the event of a Carrington-like catastrophe, an event that in today's modern world would have dire consequences for civilization. Then there is the appearance of a rare black moon, which of itself would not be associated with solar coronas, except that this appearance coincides with a supermoon. According to the Farmer's Almanac, the black supermoon will be at its closest point to the Earth and will darken the sky on July 31st, and this will allow for incredible stargazing. This is the time to look to the sky. Asteroids and large meteors continue making close approaches to the Earth in 2019. Two newly discovered asteroids flew past the planet within a 24-hour period. On July 28th, a space rock designated 2019 OD3 came within 117,000 miles of the Earth. It was first observed by the Atlas MLO in Mauna Loa, Hawaii, just one day prior. Its estimated diameter was between 36 and 82 feet, and it was traveling at 40,264 miles per hour. This was the 33rd known asteroid to fly by Earth within one lunar distance since the start of the year, and it was the 7th for the month of July. Then on July 29th, a space rock that belongs to the Apollo group of asteroids, designated 2019 ON3, flew past Earth at a distance of 131,997 miles, as observed by the Pan-STARRS 2 telescope in Hawaii. Its estimated diameter was between 24 and 52 feet, and it was traveling at 31,675 miles per hour. This became the 34th known asteroid to fly by Earth within one lunar distance since the start of the year, and it became the 8th for the month of July. We are living in unusual times, and the world is getting more crazy and dangerous by the day. World events are accelerating, and people are becoming more apprehensive. Scientists keep informing the public that it is just a matter of time before a devastating solar storm, similar to the one that was felt in North America some 160 years ago, will strike our planet once again. Much like the Carrington event of the 19th century, today's society will be completely unprepared when it strikes. So all we can do at this point is sit back and hope that our planet escapes yet another threat from space. Thanks for watching.